Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, everybody tuning in. Supertees here with another PvP walkthrough, and in this video I am playing a Restoration Shaman versus a Rep Paladin Hunter Discipline Priest. I think it's important that you understand in these matchups against Hunters that Adaptation is a powerful defensive cooldown, especially if you're Orc and you need to make sure that you're an Orc Shaman. This way, you will be only Adaptationing out of Freezing Trap. Hammer of Justice will not trigger it because its stun is reduced to a duration that does not trigger Adaptation when you are Orc. And the main thing you want to be avoiding in this match is the Priest's Psychic Scream. If you can kite the Priest and use your Earthbind and Earthgrab totems to snare him when he makes his advances, then you will almost always certainly be avoiding a Freezing Trap on a nice cycle, which then also allows you access to the Earthen Wall totem as a powerful defense during their engagements. So at the start of the fight, you want to look to be 40 yards away from the target being attacked. In this case is the Priest. And as soon as you see their Priest running at you, you need to use a Ghost Wolf and kite away, because what did I say? Avoiding Psychic Scream at all costs. The Hunter starts the game with a Grappling Hook, and this is to bait my Grounding Totem on Freezing Trap. If you don't give it, then they will just stall it out or potentially land it. In this position, the Rep Paladin has activated Avenging Wrath. I'm being chased by two members who want to crowd control me, and this is the highest amount of damage the Rep Paladin can do. So I use Earthen Wall Totem on my teammate to reduce that incoming damage and deal with it while I'm still stressed with two members chasing me. The Hunter secures his Freezing Trap, but I am now able to have my Adaptation trigger and avoid that incoming crowd control. I once again reposition away from the Priest and try my best to pre-tremor the fear as he made his advance there. Unfortunately, he was incapacitated at the same second. And this is the difficulty that you will run into as a Restoration Shaman, is when you have to run away from the Priest and also stay 40 yards away from the Rep Paladin to avoid Hammer of Justice. Because I was not able to avoid either, my Priest had to use two powerful defensive cooldowns as a result of positioning. So for the rest of the game, I need to be looking to be away from the Priest and still 40 yards away from the target, which is my Priest, not to be too confusing. You can see the Hunter on my face looking to secure Freezing Trap, and the Grappling Hook is a good animation. And typically they will want to Freezing Trap while you're grappling hooked, so you're held in place. That isn't to say that they can't trap you, such as this. You just want to look to stall it as long as you can and hold the Hunter in a position where he's not doing damage to his target. As a survival Hunter, he can't always be attacking the target and Freezing Trap you like that. He can, however, do it during Aspect of the Hawk, which is enough for another 50 seconds. So you're just stalling the Hunter when he does that. Keep your eyes on the Priest. He's chasing me, so I have to kite away. And running through the Rep Paladin is a bit dangerous. As I said, you'll be in range for Hammer of Justice. This map limits you quite heavily with where we're positioned at the moment in terms of where I can run. They do manage to get my Adaptation with Mind Control. I did not have a Wind Shear, potentially had Grounding. That's what you wanted to avoid, right? That's why I said at the beginning is you don't want that Adaptation triggered on anything other than Freezing Trap, or you get in a position like this where you're in a Hammer of Justice, potentially Freezing Trap. And this Hunter is very intelligent. He knows the defensive mechanisms. My Priest tried to Life Grip to dodge the Freezing Trap, so he held on to it and then trapped me at the end of my destination. And that moment could have been quite scary, but my Priest did a good job of kiting. In this position, we've set up triple crowd control and we are trying to burst down the Priest. While we're bursting down the healer, I look to hex the DPS that can help him the most. In that position, it's the Rep Paladin, because he can heal the Priest during a stun. That hex on the Rep Paladin got his trinket because he wanted to heal the Priest, and now later on we may be able to kill the Rep Paladin in a stun. It's at this point that the enemy team tries to make a swap and a surprise attack. Avenging Wrath is an incredibly powerful cooldown, and you have to acknowledge it immediately. So during that Avenging Wrath, I use Astral Shift and Earthen Wall Totem combined together to survive the attack. Both Execution Sentence and Wake of Ashes will do close to 60 to 80% of your health in two global cooldowns. If you do not respect those cooldowns and trade immediately, you will often die in that position. Once again, now I've noticed that they are going after me a lot more as the primary target, so I then use Ghost Wolf, and running the Nazarite trait Pack Spirit and an Honor talent Spectral Recovery makes my Ghost Wolf more potent than any of my other heals when in regards to recovering my own health bar. In this position, the Discipline Priest sneaks in a drink, which we should have looked to deny as it was a significant win condition that we had that has now been lost, but that trinket that I forced earlier with Hex is putting the Rep Paladin heavily on the back foot. So you do want to look for hex opportunities when you can and it's safe to do so. And that's usually out of another crowd control like Psychic Scream. In this position, the priest is chasing me. So what I do is Spirit Walker's Grace and move away while casting hex on them. So now they are crowd controlled for 8 seconds. And then I use Earthbind to hold them in place and snare them and continue kiting away. You've basically got to keep your eyes on two locations. You've got a priest running at you, and occasionally you have a hunter jumping at you, and either one of them could close the game if they secure enough crowd control on you, and your main prerogative is to delay it. So while I'm caught in grappling hook root, I use grounding totem. Now the hunter has to trap me while I'm moving, and look how much more time I'm wasting on his part. They end up overlapping cooldowns, and we end up getting divine shield because the enemy team was so distracted trying to crowd control me, and that's why it's important to have that stall. You want to stall it out as long as you can. Now, once again, the priest ran in towards me and I hexed him on his way in to stall the Psychic Scream. I then kite away with Earth Grab. And normally you'd want to be using Earth Grab on the melee DPS, right? You don't want them attacking their target. But Red Paladins and Hunters are highly mobile with Blessing of Freedom against a Shadow Priest that can't move that fast. So it is just better to use Earthbind and Earth Grab on the Disciplined Priest who doesn't have that same mobility and avoid his crowd control. So in this position, you see Avenging Wrath, but I predict the incoming crowd control and activated Earthen Wall Totem before it was landed. It reduced a lot of damage, but because the Avenging Wrath lasts longer than the Earthen Wall, they were able to also get dispersion. And in that position, Earthen Wall is not that powerful versus Avenging Wrath because it only reduces a small amount of damage per hit when Avenging Wrath hits you for a huge number. So a small percentage of a huge number is not a lot, so you're likely to have to use dispersion during those attempts, and dispersion will be available for every Avenging Wrath, so it's a fair trade. That's where you would want to be making that trade as a healer. My team sets up with a triple fear, and I wanted to look to hex. Anytime my team is setting up crowd control, I want to follow up and continue the chain, and that's when I look for my windows of opportunity. But getting aggressive like that cost me my adaptation. I got too close to the priest and he was able to Psychic Scream me. I'm running low on mana, and now the hunter can secure a freezing trap. The way that he's been playing, he also may be tracking my grounding totem in this position, but I've been often grounding every time he roots, so he may have thought that I'd change my mind game and not ground instantly to go for that trap. It's more likely that he's tracking it, but I would say using grounding totem during the root effect is the most primary time you want to be using grounding totem versus a hunter, because you can't avoid it any other way. Then use Ghost Wolf. In this position, I'm kiting the Red Paladin further into the open and away from my Shadow Priest so that they can burst him down, and with some crowd control initiated by my priest onto their priest, we're able to find just enough damage to kill the Ret Paladin. So thank you guys for tuning in for my walkthrough of Restoration Shaman in this specific match. I hope that there was some insight that you can pull away from it. I'm doing my best to make a guide every single day for the channel, so if you're interested in this content, definitely consider subscribing and hitting the notification bell. I really do appreciate all of the support, and I read the comments down below, so if you have any feedback or questions, I do my best to answer them as soon as I can and always. So thank you once again for tuning in, and I'll see you on the next one.